Hi, horse people. Okay, so sometimes I just scan. I mean, it's just luck of the draw if I read somebody's email, because look, I think my emails are up to 5,600 unread emails. So every day I kind of check to see if like somebody's using my credit card or there's something important, and I'll scan through the topics. But if you send me an email, the odds are I'm not gonna read it or see it or get back to you. Sorry about that. Someday, maybe I'll sit down and read all 5,000, which will be 10,000 in the next year or two, unread emails. But anyway, somehow this video got to me, and the person asked, maybe she asked in one of the comments, can you review the video and tell me why these ponies would take this baby's foal? So this is what another thing that I see as misinformation in the horse world. Like in many things, you get people online and they give their opinion, and they really have no facts or basis for it, but people believe it. Now, my opinion's still only an opinion, so I'm not saying I couldn't be wrong, but the odds are I'm right more than I am wrong. But this is just my opinion. I really don't know what happened, but here's I'm going to tell you what I see from my experience with horses. Let's take a look at this. So did this thing start? Okay, so the next day it says the mama had a baby and the baby's drinking. Okay, we got it. Is there music playing? Okay, there is dramatic music, which to me, when people start doing things like that, they're trying to push their agenda or what they see, or they're trying to ex make you think what they're saying is more correct because it has dramatic music, just like the movies do. So I'm going to go ahead and mute this because I don't really want to hear the music. So it says you can see them eating grass. The foal is taking a first bite. First of all, foals usually don't eat very quick. It's usually several days afterwards. But if this is the first day, I'm kind of surprised this baby is eating grass, because a lot of babies will just be on a mama for quite a while. I mean, a week or 2 weeks. I mean, I don't have a whole lot of experience with raising babies from babies, but from what I see, they usually don't eat grass right away. So the fact that the baby's eating grass tells me it's not 1 day old. Could be wrong. So mom and baby are grazing. Baby does look kind of wobbly, big kneed. But then, and the dramatic music starts. Dun 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 dun. But then, oh, look at the mean horses coming. Oh, look at the mean. This is where the music is very dramatic. This horse isn't coming in to be aggressive or mean, in my opinion. So of course, mom is nervous of the baby. And all wild horses or any herds, they like to check out, which is why moms normally walk away from the herd to have their baby. They don't want the afterbirth in the middle of the herd. They want to get, in case it attracts predators, so they try to get in an isolated area. They don't get too far from the herd, but they get away from the herd. And the herd is always curious and wanting to come over and check out the new baby. I mean, it's just like freaking humans. When a baby's born, everybody wants to go, oh, look cute, let me hold it. It's same thing with horses. Like, holy shit, there's a new herd member. Well, let me, now I got somebody that's lower than me. Every horse is like, wow, man, hope this baby isn't higher than me. But they come over and they check it out. And they may push it a little bit, but this is normal behavior for me. So again, the dramatic music plays. Dun, 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 dun. Okay, so they're trying to say that the Shetlands try to protect the baby. Look, they stick together because they're a herd. And this baby is on the outside, which tells me the mom and the rest of the herd's kind of ignorant. Rick, you can't call her that. She's a single mom, and you gotta, she's always doing that. All right, whatever. All horses are single moms. Sorry. Okay. But they usually have more sense than humans, but this mom does not know how to keep the baby in the middle of herd. So I don't know if it's an inexperienced mom, if it's an old mom, if mom's weak, if there's issues going on. Mom looks kind of weak. Maybe because she just had a baby. I don't know. But she doesn't keep her baby on the inside and make a barrier of herself between her and the baby. It's almost like she's pushing the baby into the damn herd. So, see, mom's kind of kicking, and she's got baby on the outside. So, mom's just kind of, you know, this video makes it seem like the mean ponies, the big horses, came and picked on the little horses. Mom wasn't doing a very good job at herding her horse. Maybe she's got a bad eye on the one side, and she keeps pushing the left. I'll have to see in the video, the rest of the video, whether or not there's always the left side where she loses track of her baby. But it just seems kind of not real good herd instincts to keep the baby in the middle of the herd versus on the outside to where it gets picked off easy. I mean, that's basic survival 101. I don't know why this pony don't get it. Rick, why are you always picking on the single moms? It's not her fault, and she's doing the best she can. Whatever. Freaking people want to make everything about sex or color or anything but facts. Okay, so mom, this look, you notice the horses are not trying to attack or kill the baby. They're curious. They're trying to check it out. Mom's freaking a freakazoid, panicking, pushing a baby into it, running around. The other ponies are there. And there's one other thing that this video does not mention, which is causing a lot of this. Who knows what it is? Who knows where I'm going to go? Come on. All you people with two brain cells rubbing together. Here we go. It's the freaking people filming and all the people around here. You're going to see people all over the place. When you get humans involved, you change it. You can't step in the same river twice. Once you put your foot in it, you change everything. You can't observe horses without affecting what happens. You change it because of your presence. So you either change it for the good or for the worse, and just because you want to paint it out and make these horses bad and make mom bad and make everything else bad. It's the freaking people that are filming and crowding and messing up this herd behavior. There's plenty of open land here where mom could probably get away. Mom probably bought the baby in because all these people are feeding them. And so the wild ponies came in because all these people are feeding them. So now they depend on people for food. And now you get too many horses in a small area. And this is what happens. This is not a horse issue. It's a human issue. Like at most 99% of the time it is. No horses are being bad or mean here, even though the baby gets stomped twice. So the baby looks confused. Mom's total panic and freakazoid. See, she keeps pushing the damn baby into... The other little ponies ain't doing nothing. But mom keeps pushing the baby into the baby. So now they're like, oh, look! The big herd of ponies and the Shetlands right in the middle. Oh my God, this big herd took advantage of the poor little horses. Oh my God, I'm waiting for it because they aren't taking the white horses. They're only taking the black horse. That'll be the new thing. Black horse lives matter, riots. Ponies will be burning down freaking neighborhoods now because they took the black pony. I mean, it's just crazy how people can't stay focused on the topic at hand. This is herd behavior. This herd of ponies is like, there's a new baby. There's a new little herd. We want to check it out. We haven't seen this person. We know these horses. We see them. We've eat. We smell their poop. We know they've been around. This one's new. Let's check out the new thing. Horses like to check out things to make sure that it's not a threat. Anytime you change an environment, you bring a saddle in. You change, you put in new mats in there. You change a gate. You move something in the arena. Horses will always react with skepticism and kind of curiosity, like, we need to make sure this is friend or foe. These horses are not trying to kill or be mean to this baby. As much as the dramatic music, if you listen. Don't.
They're taking his fur.
Oh no, they took it. Oh, how sad. How sad. Mom kicks. Oh, she's trying to save her pony. Notice the active tail of the mom. Notice the arched head trying to look bigger, trying to fend off and show these horses, leave me alone. Now, the horses are kind of ignoring mom. I got that. But look at the people filming. Listen to the people talking with the music behind it. They're affecting all this, probably causing it. So, again, ponies are there trying to check out. The baby's just kind of like, I don't know where to go. I'm not with mom. I'm confused, too. horses were scared to fight anything. They're not. Look. But then she has lost her foal. Oh, she lost it. She ran away. Maybe she said, you know what? I'm being in the middle of it, kicking and everything. It's probably better if I just leave. Maybe it'll calm down. Maybe the horse was thinking with more brain cells than the human. But no. The human saw it with the dramatic music. But then she lost her baby. Okay, so mom comes back in, goes away, comes back in. I mean, mom is self-surviving. She doesn't want to get close enough to get struck, so she's not risking her life, but she's showing, when I talk about Buddy, sometimes he'll protest kick, and horses will protest kick, and people will take it as a major offense that the horse is trying to kill him, and it tried to kick my head off, and that horse is disrespectful, and mom is protesting right now. I want my baby. She's being active. She's kind of, mom's not trying to kill this person. If this was a stupid human trying to round pin mom and mom kicked like this, it'd be like, she's disrespectful. She tried to kill me. I better show her who's boss and I've got to treat her like crap, put big bits on her, beat her with a whip and run her till she's exhausted. No. Mom is like trying to communicate with body language. Hey, I want my baby. You're interfering. Leave me alone. But notice they're running around in front of the human filming. Don't forget about the human filming and talking and all the people creating a draw with food. She goes back and disaster happens. So look, it's pretty calm right here, right now, okay? Mom's like, okay, I got my baby. I kind of think mom has a seeing issue because she just doesn't seem to be reacting normal. So these two horses are here. Baby and the other horse is smelling each other. No problem. Mom kind of gets pushy on the male horse. Notice mom moved in. Horse was fine with the baby. Mom moves in and encroaches. Mom is approaching this horse like humans approach. Straight eyes, reaching out, trying to grab, threatening, predator-like, aggressive, pushy. Mom pushes in on this horse. Mom creates a strike. Rick, how can you say that? She's a single mom and she can't do anything wrong and she's always right and you're just picking on her because she's a... Whatever. She causes the strike. The horse is not trying to kick the baby, although it does. Now, the baby's okay and it's running around later, so for everybody that just, you know, is going to put in the comments, I couldn't keep watching. It's so sad. I was eating and I can't eat anymore. I just can't watch your videos, Rick. They're too aggressive. Well, okay. Then don't watch. Sorry. I mean, this is going to ruin your dinner. The baby got kicked in the head. It's not good. It gets up and it runs around later. Mom, the herd, the humans all cause this. So, look, I've seen moms correct a foal harsher than what this horse did. I've seen moms literally bite and attack a baby at the shoulders and flatten them with their teeth on the ground when they misbehave. Matter of fact, I think Buddy might have got corrected by his mom that way. I mean, just Buddy went over and tried to be friends to another horse, and mom said no, and he didn't listen, and I think she grabbed him right and just flattened him. If it wasn't on Buddy, it was on Buddy's sister. But, I mean, look, moms can be pretty damn aggressive when they correct a baby. And babies can take a lot of abuse. So, they're young, they're growing, etc. I'm not justifying this horse is right, mom's wrong. You know, I'm just telling you, things happen. And again, you notice this video keeps cutting in and out. So I don't know what's happening in between, whether the humans are getting involved. So, did I just see shoes on that horse? Right here, did I see shoes? Okay, that's just the sole. That's a good natural trim. Okay, there's no shoes. It almost looked like shoes a little bit. Sorry. So mom, again, friendly people I'm worried about. Mom's pushing a horse into the people. I just don't get it. This freaking horse could be so easy to put herself over here and push the baby to the other ponies in the middle. Nope. Mom's keeping it away from everybody. Rick, she's a single mom and she's doing a great job and it's not her fault and it's everyone else's. So this right here is a little bit, some people would call snaking. I don't even think this horse is snaking. I think he's kind of warning the other horses stay away and he's trying to smell the baby. But maybe he's snaking the baby. I don't think he's trying to steal it. I'm sorry. So this pony kind of came in. It could move its butt right here and stop and stand and stop this horse. Remember, horses, you win when you stop their movement or you make them move or you control what direction they move. If this horse backed its butt in here, it would stop the forward movement of this horse. Baby's like, holy shit, what the hell did I get into? Freaking crazy world. Again, smelling. Not trying to steal. Not trying to kill. Smelling. Checking out new baby. Mom's panicking. Mother goes crazy. Bump, bump, bump. I'm sure there's some good music there. Hang on, let's hear this good music. Mom goes crazy. Oh my God. What is this? They're playing like the sound of the helicopters coming in, attacking a beach. Oh my goodness. Drama. Oh, believe me. It's the mean horses. Oh, come on, people. All right. So mom's obviously panicking, probably calling, circling, trying to get the baby to come. She's trying to create a draw. Notice the people. Everybody notice that? Happens to be a woman there. Shocking. Wow. Who could have predicted that? A woman wearing pink in the middle of horse crisis. Who the hell? Ray Charles saw that shit coming. Rick, you're just picking. Whatever. Right in the middle of it. Right in the middle of it. You got a person filming and women running around and they're blaming everything on the other horse, taking no responsibility for what they're doing and causing. There's only one option. Oh my God, what's he? Okay, so these horses are wild. They're saying they're wild, but yet they have collars on. But Rick, maybe this horse stuck his head somewhere and you're just picking on it because you don't like blondes. All right, whatever. Sniffing, checking out, curious. Nobody's trying to kill anybody when the humans and other ponies and everybody aren't panicking and trapped in a small area. Notice the difference when there's not involvement. A little horse just nuzzled him. Look at him. Ricky's trying to bite him. We need to save him and separate him. And that horse is wild. And I need to come in and... Good girl. Good girl. Good girl. This is a good pony. Good girl. This horse is mean and wild and trying to bite him. And this mean, bad breeding and lack of oxygen. Good girl. Good girl. Good girl. Who do I sound like? Freaking another idiot in the horse world. Okay, so mom comes in, kicks, turns her head. You notice when she kicks, the head is always canted a little bit. She's trying to get that peripheral vision on her baby. She's trying to make sure that I don't want to kick it. So she's got to keep that one eye over here. She kicked. The other horse said, hey, don't kick me. I'll kick you. Okay, well, that's normal. I don't see anything dangerous or bad or mean here. I see mom not pushing her baby away. She's on the outside pushing a baby again into, well, she had another horse there. Okay, I'll give her a little credit there. Again, the video keeps getting cut. Mom's all over baby trying to kick them. Now the baby's in front of another pony. See, this is when people, look at all the people. Woman. Gee, I wonder how many have cookies. Wonder if anybody, Rick, they wouldn't bring a cookie out there. That would be stupid. Oh, okay. I'm sorry. I must be misjudging them. Okay. When you have crowding like this, this is when accidental kicks and a baby gets kicked in the head or another pony gets a leg broke because of humans. Too many horses, small area, a draw. This baby is creating a big draw right now. it's a draw of curiosity, and they want to know, and they want to check it out. And then the mom's trying to protect it, so it's creating chaos. And then the stupid human's trying to film it. And then the women are bringing cookies. All right, maybe there's a man bringing a cookie. Whatever. Again, look at freaking mom. Baby's on the outside to what you're trying to protect it from. This mom just doesn't, I don't get it. She's not the sharpest freaking mom out there. Just like all humans, just because you can have a kid doesn't mean you should. This horse doesn't seem real smart. Look at her. Turns and blocks her baby's path. But Rick, she had to go back and save it. The baby couldn't keep up, but it's tired. It's not it. And you're just picking on her. Whatever. So now mom rears up. Baby's there. Okay, now she's in a good position. She's got herself between the other horses and the baby. I get it. And finally, they get her away. If mom can keep her without pushing her into the damn herd. And they're moving away from the stupid humans. And the herd is away from the stupid humans. And it's better because there's distance from the filmer and the stupid humans. Baby's really slow. See, the herd, that's why the saying survival of the fittest. If you can't keep up with the herd, then you get sacrificed. Baby's not keeping up. The herd is getting away and getting to safety. Mom is staying with the baby trying to protect it, but the baby can't keep up with the herd. And this would be the same thing as if a predator came in. But then the foal is knocked over again. Hang on, I'm sure there's dramatic music here. Let's see. Oh my God, it's knocked over by mom again. Oh, it's horrible. Baby is getting clumsy and tired and confused. And there's all kind of confusion. And mom's kicking and the babies are kicking. Wait a minute. Did I see women out there trying to help? Yeah, look at all the people trying to make it. Look at all the innocent people watching. Rick, there's a man there. There's also three women in pink. But anyway, look at all the people not taking responsibility. So we have the person filming with all the people around the person. And then we have all these people in the middle. But no, Rick, it's the mean horse that came over and tried to steal the baby. I hope you guys understand to look at things more critically. Look at all these freaking people. One, two, three. A dog with a woman. But she has to bring her dog, Rick, because she had dog cookies and the dog likes the horses. And they're just trying to help Rick. And there'll be all these excuses on why I'm just picking on the stupid humans. They all go their ways. Hang on, I'm sure there's happy, good music here. Dun, dun, dun. And it's over. Gee. What is missing out of this picture? Not a bunch of stupid humans standing around. Shocker. All right. So, look. I get it, people. People will see things differently. I could be all wrong. I could be 100% wrong, and this horse is just an aggressive, mean, bully, mean male horse that was picking on poor single mom and her baby. I could be wrong, but I freaking doubt it. All right? We'll end that there. Buddy, Miss T, you're good boys.